This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Today we're gonna see how we can create the invert and flicker effect and transition in Final Cut Pro 10 without any plugins required. We're in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface. We have placed the footage that we will see how the effect is gonna work in Final Cut Pro 10, but first of all, let's talk about the invert effect. The invert effect, you have probably seen it in a lot of videos, is this effect that changes the colors, let's say the black turns into white, or the white areas turn into colorized areas. It's very easy to do in programs like Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Resolve, but in Final Cut Pro 10, the effect is not under the name Invert, but you can find it by going to the Effects panel, Looks, and it's the X-ray option. Now, as you saw in the beginning, I used this effect as a transition. You can use it on your videos as well, but it works great with the transitions. And if you have watched my other videos on custom transitions, and you will see some links dropping like crazy right now on top of the screen, you see that I love using adjustment layers. And if you don't have adjustment layers, you will see a video popping right now to learn what adjustment layers are, and of course to download yours for free. Now, I'm gonna go into the titles, into the adjustment layers, and I'm gonna drag a small adjustment layer, place it where I want the transition to take place, and I'm not gonna place the effects that I'm gonna put on the videos. I'm gonna put them on the adjustment layer because also I can make some other adjustments that we will see later on the video. Let's go and see how we can create this effect. We are between these two clips, and I'm gonna drag the adjustment layer here, and I'm gonna count 1, 2 frames. Let me zoom into the timeline by pressing Command Plus. I'm gonna select the adjustment layer with the timeline here, and I'm gonna press Command B to blade it. The additional way is to press B in my keyboard and blade it. I just want it to be only 2 frames. Now I'm gonna drag the X-ray from the looks and placing into the adjustment layer, and you see that as soon as I've done that, I already have the invert effect as a transition. But I'm not gonna stay there, and you know that I like to make my tutorials a little bit more complicated as the time goes by, so stay on this video, don't leave right away, because this was not the effect, there are more things to come. Let me take a moment before we continue with the tutorial to talk a little bit about Squarespace. If you don't have a website, and having a website if you're a photographer, videographer or YouTuber is a must, showcasing your portfolio, showcasing your skills and having an online presence, Squarespace is an online platform where you can get your domain or build your own website without having any knowledge at all at web design or web developing. You can use high-end designers templates that you can use them as a structure and start building your own website without having, I'm saying that again, any knowledge at all at web design. So if you're interested in building your online presence, head over to squarespace.com/Emilio. You can try it for free first, and then when you're ready to buy, you can use the coupon code Emilio and get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Also, if you create your website by using the link that you will see in the description of this video down below, you help supporting this channel. Let's go back into the tutorial now. And I'm gonna show what other things we can do in the transition between these two clips. Now, keep in mind, we created an adjustment layer, and that helps us to simply select that, press Option in my keyboard and duplicate it, because I want it to be the beginning of my whole process. I have the X-ray there, and now I'm gonna change the duration into 1 frame. So I'm pressing right in my keyboard, 1 frame, I'm dragging and dropping this here, and then I'm gonna start duplicating by pressing Option in my keyboard and click on it and drag it to the right, or you can always use the Command C, Command V to copy and paste. As you can see right now, I have three adjustment layers with the X-ray effects that they're coming into the next clip. If I go into the effects panel again and go into color, I can drag the colorize. And what I'm gonna do is the second one, I'm gonna make it red. Let's go into the spectral panel. You see here on the colorize that we can change the remap black, what my black is gonna be. For example, I can set it to green and then the remap white to, let's say, cyan. And we will have something like that. And also on the final, we can select and go into the spectral panel after we place colorize and change it to something more bluish. So I'm gonna change the white to blue and the black to cyan. Now you will see that what we created is again the same effect, but with more colors, like an RGB effect or a split. Pretty cool, pretty easy. And let's go into the other transition. I'm gonna cut again the adjustment layer with the option to duplicate it. And now let's do something different. This is again our basic adjustment layer with the X-rays effect. The duration is one frame. I'm gonna make it two frames again. I'm gonna place it here again. I'm gonna duplicate it, and I'm gonna duplicate it two times, but with a little bit more duration this time, two frames. And on the first one, I'm gonna keep it on the X-ray, but what I'm gonna do, my favorite bad TV effect. And also I'm gonna place the bad TV effect at the end of it. Also, another thing that I can do is to select the middle one or all of them. Let's select all of them. Go into the inspector panel on the right and we can change the scale all, let's say, to 165%. So, as you can see, using adjustment layers, you can have multiple effects. We can start with the invert that we saw, it's the X-ray effect, and then we can be as much creative as we want. We can add the bad TV to create some glitch and invert effect, and we can change the scale on the transform so we can have a zoom in while we're making the transition. Let's play that to see. And it reminds us also a glitch transition. If you want to be more precise on the flicker effect, remember that we can do this. Now, if you want to be more precise of creating an invert and a flicker effect, if you haven't seen one of my oldest videos with a flicker text effect tutorial, you're gonna see a link right now popping with a text flicker effect. But what you can do is to create cuts. And what I mean by that is that this is two frames, okay? Let's say that we want the adjustment layers to be three frames or four frames, okay? Let's make it six, okay? I decided six frames. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and again this, one, two, three, four, five, six. I'm gonna drag them, place them in the middle, and now I'm selecting the first adjustment layer. One frame to the right, and by having selected, Command B and blading. We continue the whole process, again, one frame to the right, and blading, or let's go and select B in our keyboard, one frame to the right, blading, one frame to the right. I'm gonna continue that and blade all the adjustment layers on top by one frame. Wonderful. And now what I'm gonna do is to select the every other adjustment layer that we cut, I'm gonna select it and delete it. And I'm gonna select all the adjustment layers in the middles, every other frame. And the result is gonna have a flicker feel on it as well. Let's play and see. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. This is a very easy effect that you can combine it to create something that will match your imagination and your creativity. Also, remember the adjustment layers. You will find the link for them to download them for free in the description of this video down below. And I can recommend more the adjustment layers. As you have already seen, if you have already seen my channel, I use them a lot in the videos, and it's very easy to add effects into the adjustment layers and then copy and paste to use them either to other sections of your video or to other videos as well. Don't forget to leave your comment if you have any questions on the effect or if you just want to say hi. Subscribe, ring the notification bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next video.